one's for you, Andrews.
Okie dokie, Thomas. Come along.
All dressed up, nowhere to go.
The news from everywhere today is excellent. The moment seems very auspicious for us to strike.
On the eve of battle, the 22nd Manchesters finally left their billets and moved up to the front line. Aside from their standard equipment, men carried 250 rounds of ammunition, 2 Mills bombs, a waterproof sheet, sandbag, field dressing, emergency ration including biscuit, smoke helmet, wire cutters, pick and shovel, with the heaviest tools carried by the strongest men. Others carried barbed wire, fence posts, field telephones, even carrier pigeons. Such was the confidence in the artillery bombardment. The men carried everything they would need to take and hold the German trenches. Sergeant Tawney described his feelings as he marched up to the front.
This immense, overwhelming tranquility of sky and down, uniting us millions of enemies and allies in its solemn, unavoidable embrace, dwarfed into insignificance the wrath of man and his feverish energy of destruction. It was a perfect evening. One forgot the object for which we were marching to the trenches.
Is that the new rest home?
Seventeen-year-old Cyril Josie was one of the lucky ones. Wounded in the first 5 minutes of the battle, he was evacuated to England.
My dearest Ive, I couldn't get back to our own lines until next morning. I didn't eat anything, but lived on pulling off dead men's water bottles. About 6 a.m. I began crawling back. Old Johnny sniped at me all the way back, but I dodged him by getting in the shell holes. I heard of our battalion, 27 answered roll call after the battle. So you can imagine, 27 out of 1,000 men. Thank you awfully for the postal order. Love to Father, Mother, Amber. Cyril. Oh, can you please send me one of those 6.5p writing tabs and some stamps, please?
Like so many others, Captain Charlie May was buried where he fell. Over the following days, a shockwave travelled through the British Isles as thousands of telegrams told mothers, wives and lovers that their men would not be coming home. The battle on the Somme ground murderously on, a bloody war of attrition, until it fizzled out in November 1916. It ended on roughly the same ground on which it had begun. Both sides bled dry. The final combined casualty figure for the British, French, and German soldiers who fought there was over 1 million dead, wounded, or missing.